Jenny from Raleigh, is there any truth to eating slower that will help you lose weight? I think we're told all kinds of different things about quick tips and, you know, little tricks to help. Well, eating slower is a good thing, and we should all practice. You're just talking about that. We should all be eating slower, right?
Yeah.
It's not a weight loss tool specifically. It can help you have the time to feel full. When our bodies have a process by which when food goes in, a lot of hormones change in order to let our brain know, okay, you were hungry, now you've eaten, and now you're full. When you eat very quickly, that process cannot go through as quickly as you're eating. And so you can overeat before you actually feel that full feeling. Yes. And that can be a problem.
Yeah, that's correct. And, you know, this, I must admit, I'm bad at this. I've been working on it for a long time, and I'm better at it than I used to be. But, you know, some of you are younger, but when you're my age, you got to realize you're not that far removed from folks who understood on a firsthand basis what happened during the Great Depression. Mm-hmm. So my grandparents lived through that, and they raised my parents in a way that, you know, there was a shortage, and you would never, ever not eat everything on your plate. I mean, this was a criminal thing. And, you know, you have to, I don't know how else to say, I'm going to try to say this in just the nicest way I can. At that time, you know, you take going to the doctor as just something you do, and most people do it, and they get medicine for this, that, and the other. Well, at that time, we didn't have all these advances. And people, in many cases, didn't go to the doctor unless they were really very, very ill, and there weren't a ton of treatments available. And so things like birth control hadn't made the scene yet. And so families were big and during this time period. And the old joke was they'd gather around to eat, and there wouldn't be enough food exactly. And so you'd say the grace. So the grace went like this: Father, Son, Holy Ghost, you eat the quickest, you get the most. Okay. And it was just your fault. If you didn't eat fast enough, you didn't get enough food. And so those folks who were familiar with those concepts raised me. And so I grew up eating fast. And then I joined the military, and it got worse because they're like, you got 5 minutes to eat, and we're going to stand here and yell at you the whole time, and you better eat it quick. All right. So the this sort of thing makes for a weird psychology that's very hard to break, even now in my mid-50s, you see. So it's something you got to work on. You got to concentrate on this. You have to and you can't. I mean, in today's world, you think about how fast we move and all that stuff. We're going from one place to the other place, or they're going to ball practice and work, ball practice. We're going to stop here, grab the pre-made meal. We're going to woof it down in the car. This is the kind of stuff that this is where eating fast gets to be a real problem. And you have to make a conscious effort to, hey, I'm going to eat this slow. Okay. Whatever the scenario is, I'm going to take my time and eat this. And when I really work on this, when I really do it, it's surprising how my grocery bill goes down because I don't end up eating as much food. Yeah. So anyway, it's I think that's the ticket to losing weight that you've made reference to here. It's not something inherently about the eating slow, for example, that raises your metabolic rate. It just allows you to eat less because it allows all the signaling to catch up with your brain.
Yes.
You say, hey, I don't need anything else, right?
Yeah, exactly. And there are some tips that we give patients sometimes to try to slow them down, using chopsticks, for instance.
Yeah, you know, yeah, I'm pretty good at that. Actually, I got really good at that. And I'm still really good at it for, you know, how shall they say in slang terminology, the standard gringo. I'm pretty good at chopsticks, even though I wouldn't fit in necessarily in a foreign country where they use those. For a guy that didn't grow up using them, I'm pretty good at it. And you can't get too much food with those things.
Exactly.
So it takes you longer to eat. You're right. That's right. Yeah.
Using smaller utensils sometimes can help, and trying to form a habit, a new habit of maybe putting the fork or spoon down between your bites. Some people will also try to count their chews. So there are different tricks that when you're trying to become a slower, more mindful, conscious eater, there are things that you can use to make it a little bit easier. So Jenny, take some of those, maybe get some chopsticks out and see how it goes. Thank you everyone for joining us. Please like this video, give us a comment, share it. We'd love to hear from you, especially if you're using chopsticks to
eat.
That's
right, that's right. Anytime, but my family or whatnot orders from a Chinese restaurant. I don't eat very much Chinese food because of the stuff that usually goes on it. It's stuff I don't eat, but I always have them get the chopsticks because they'll eat it with a fork, but I save the chopsticks. I keep them in my silverware drawer. Yep. So this is funny.
I keep them too.
There's all these little packs of soy sauce and the chopsticks in there. So, oh gosh. Okay.